Wagwan, what's great? Chef Adrian Morris again, man, presenting to you how to make stir fry. Quick and easy, less than 20 minutes. Prep time is around 15 minutes, thereabout, give and take. But the cooking time is quite quick and easy.
We know about sardine, yeah. Mackerel, yeah. Bully beef, yeah. Chicken foot, yeah. Chicken neck, yeah. Chicken back. Nothing our waste, nothing our dash way.
And I just have here a list of the ingredients that I'm going to be using, which are inexpensive. Most expensive one is probably the chicken breast. And I know you guys may be wondering, you haven't seen a video of me so long. It's been a while. I have videos, like older videos that I've been putting out, whereas when I went back to Jamaica and stuff like that. And for those of you who may know me personally, you may also recognize that I'm gaining a few pounds. I've recently started the good life, literally. You know what I say, at the good life fitness, and I'm going to the gym. I told myself from last time I'm going to the gym, but this is not really about the gym. It's just me saying I've been absent, been just working through a few things, but still trying to put out a video, probably 2 videos per month, but I'm going to be putting out way more videos, right? So I know cooking is my thing. So for all of those who want to see me when I'm not in the kitchen, follow my new Instagram, because my old Instagram got deleted. So my new Instagram is now hot_chef. So you can follow that Instagram for daily updates on the stories and what I'm basically up to, as well as keep up with me through my vlog channel, which is Gamp TV. You know what I say? A link of it will be right here and also here. You know what I say? Yeah. So this stir fry now, just a quick thing when you're hungry, man, and you want to eat. I mean, I have a lot of people been reaching out and say, "Chef, we miss you. Where have you been?" As you can see, it's a total different setup, because I moved probably in February and we're now in almost July, you know what I say? So yeah, just a few changes. This kitchen is not the best for lighting, so right now it's after 5 in the afternoon, and we're in Canada, so the lighting is a bit better. I have to open the windows because there's no physical window in this kitchen, and you know me, I want to give you quality looking videos, but just work with this for now until I figure out the light sourcing in this place. You know what I say? But without further delay, I just want to jump into this quick and easy stir fry. Chicken stir fry at that, with some chow mein noodles. You get them I thought from? And the ingredients are quite simple. We have here half of a white French onion. We also have about quarter of a head of broccoli. And over here we have some bell peppers. And this is half of a yellow bell pepper. Normally I'd use yellow, green, but I don't have that. And the yellow will provide more color for you and more flavor, right? Because we have those broccolis which are green already. And over here we have some green onions known as scallions, right? And we'll just rough chop those. And then we have some minced garlic and of course scotch bonnet, because I love a bit of heat in whatever I'm eating. And I have here 2 whole eggs. And then over here we have probably a 1 pound chicken breast. And this is bone on, so we're just gonna debone that and then work away from there, right? Over here I have a rolling pin that's gonna be used for my chicken. I also have a chef's knife, a fork, a paring knife, and a pair of tongs, right? And then right here now we have some chow mein noodles, and this is gonna add to our stir fry. Then over here now I have some white distilled vinegar, some soya sauce, all-purpose seasoning, salt and pepper, and that's basically it. So just get chicken breast started, but you can do this overnight, because you don't know, when the chicken marinate, it gives you absolute great flavor, so try that out. See, just gonna remove this from the bone. You know what I say, I have a video out on how to debone a whole chicken, but this I'm going to go as close as possible to the bone, because we don't want to waste none of the breast. You see me, my breast one, you know, so I'm the best man for the breast, man. And of course, I don't know, this can be used for some stock. So we're not, as I was saying at the intro, you know. Yeah, man, I just said it, man. So this chicken right here, me normally. Sometimes I even cook it. I don't know, man, love them chicken back too, you know. Curry chicken back, where they make my brown stew some. But this right here, we can store this with some proper stock, you know what I say? Don't dash it up with people. Nothing better than bone, like full of flavor, you see? Turn this over. I'm just gonna cut this off. And the goal here is to have this chicken breast as even as possible. Because one thing you have to understand about chicken breast, it's easy to cook. When we say easy, like easy. So the reason why I have the rolling pin is to roll that chicken out to get it all on one level so that they cook evenly and at the same time. You don't want some of the chicken breast cook and then the chicken dry out and a bag of things, you see me? You don't want that. And one more thing that I'm missing from this recipe, you can use that if you have it at home, some nice fresh ginger. That's something that's bad, you know. Cut this like that. It's not the hardest part about it, trust me. The prep time, which is about 15 minutes as I explained earlier. Because you have to give them the fact, so you have to season it up. Cut up your vegetables and stuff like that, you see me? Nice little strips, yeah. So add some cold water to that. You don't know, the vinegar have to go in at the thing. Just give that a nice little wash. Get rid of that rawness, man. You don't know thing. If you have some lime, you can also put some lime into this, is it? We have that wash and drain to an extent. We're gonna go in with about half teaspoon of salt and pepper mix. 2 tablespoons of all-purpose seasoning, is it me? Because you don't know the thing going on. Them say, when you know if you stop, when your ancestor ball out, stop! Just gonna mix this out. That's what we have. And as I say, I don't have no camera, so that's why I don't get them nice shot down and I'm gonna get it. I'm gonna go in with some coconut oil. You get the man food from? Because I like cooking coconut oil. About 3 tablespoons there about. There's a little bit of liquid in here. We're just gonna drain that off with our tongue. Again, overnight is best. Drop them right in. That's the sound you want to hear. Medium high, pan on. I'm just gonna separate these so they cook evenly. Gonna add our white onion. Gonna add my garlic and spice bunny. And the reason why we add the garlic and spice bunny afterwards, because we don't want to burn the garlic. You know garlic burns easily, you know what I'm saying? We need the flavor, but we don't want it burn. Then the broccoli and the pepper. Alright, at this point, I'm gonna add my noodles. I'm gonna switch to a bigger frying pan. You see me? Because I like to saute stuff in this because for some reason it's better for me. So a bigger frying pan just for the space. But if you have a big frying pan that works well with sauteing, use that just one pot type of vibe. I'm gonna hit that pan with a little bit of oil. Just like a teaspoon. Quickly whisk up my egg and add those in. Adding in my green onions. Push that to the side. Then add back my vegetables, you see me? No oil or anything else. Just gonna add that back to that pot. Normally if I wasn't changing over the pan, then I'll just eat everything like this and then just do the egg to the side. But because I need a bigger pan to finish off everything, and then we're gonna season that now with the soy sauce. So about 2 tablespoons. So we don't add no, you realize we didn't add any salt on the, what you call it? We didn't add no salt on the eggs because we have the soya sauce already. You see? Just before that eggs, we're gonna hit that now with the noodles. The noodles are already cooked, just straight in. We're not gonna strain these noodles or anything. Proper. Give myself a generous to this portion.
Quick and easy chicken stir fry with chow mein noodles. You know what I say? Add some red peppers for color and variation. And even more flavor.
Nice and cool outside. Thank you Father God for this food I'm about to eat. Thank you for the hands who prepare it, and thank you for those who provide it. In your precious name, amen. So yeah, I eat this right now, then head to the gym. Broccoli's still nice and crunchy. You see me? The noodles are good. Not too much. Remember, I didn't put any salt in that water that I boiled the noodles in. And the chicken is perfectly cooked. So I'm trying to cut down on the sodium. Less salt. You see me? Now you could add to this as well. Forget the thing looking more vibrant in terms of color. Can you know me? Color. But quick meal before the gym, as I must say. I'm gonna put some mixed vegetables in this, you know what I say? To kinda bring out the color more. It's vegetables, right? Could add that in there. Add a little bit more soy sauce if you want it saltier, but this for me is perfect, isn't it? It have a little bit of juice from the noodles. If you like people want to follow my Snapchat, come. Follow my Instagram, @_chef. You see me? For daily updates, come updates by my Snapchat and my Instagram daily on the story. Not a lot of cooking stuff. Because as I say, I've recently been trying to go to the gym and figure out stuff, you see me? From certain angles may look thin, while other angles may look bigger, you see me? But I'm getting there. I used to be 130 pounds a month ago I started. I know I'm 140 pounds, you see me? Really and truly, results will only come if you work. That's the only thing I have for you, the only solution to getting anything, you see me? Sorry for the slow video then, as I say. The camera that I started on YouTube, which is now done, the camera that you're seeing right now is my vlogging camera. Yes, it may be showing clear, but for the food, I don't think it gives the food that detail that I would want for you to see, like some of my previous videos. You know, you can't drop the standard, you have to go higher and higher. Try out this recipe, tell me if you like it, as I say. Usually, I'd make my noodles in salt, I never did that, just took a oyster then a stick. Usually, I'd add a bit more soy sauce, but no, I'm cutting back on my salt intake, you see me? Less sodium to my thing. Because man, I got the gym, you know the thing work. But don't get me wrong. So I'm gonna make the authentic Jamaican dishes. We have the exact recipe, fit flavor. Me now go put nothing sharp because of my journey. Me now go into the thing them the realest way. Cause sometimes we sacrifice nutrition for tradition and taste. Don't tell yourself no lie. But leave that in the comment section for your discussion, isn't it? But yeah man, thank you very much for watching again. If you're not subscribed as yet, subscribe. And if you're subscribed already, ensure if you hit that bell. That way you can get notified for each post that I put out as soon as I put them out, isn't it? Thank you very much for the support. Thank you very much for the understanding. Thank you for following me on Instagram for build up by the community. I lost over 4,000 people over there because of the deletion. But we're back, we're up again. One video at least per week. Until we get back a camera, I'm going to try to put up 2 videos a week. But you know that's something that go already. I love cooking. When I now cook, it's like it just drain the energy from. You see me? So yeah, when I go continuously see cooking videos from Chef Maurice, you see me? So once again, thank you very much for watching. And make sure you take care of yourself, you know. Safe travel on the gravel. And go and big up on yourself.
Cause I'm any man can feed you. So that's why you always take me to the kitchen. Yeah, yeah, yeah.